It's time once again for America's favorite show, The Radio Adventures of Dr. Floyd, brought to you by DrFloyd.com.
This week, starring Jeffrey Tambor as George Washington and Leslie Carrara-Rudolph as Martha Washington.
In our last action-packed episode, evil mastermind Dr. Steve and his sock-shaped assistant Fidget had made a time jump to the year 1791 in order to steal the false teeth of the first president of the United States, George Washington. Hot on their heels, however, was our hero, the world's most brilliant scientist, Dr. Floyd, along with his young protege, Dr. Grant, and their faithful robot companion, Chips, who have just landed in Philadelphia in 1791.
Wow, Dr. Floyd, I can't believe we're in Philadelphia in 1791.
I know, Dr. Grant, it is pretty exciting.
Where do you think Dr. Steve is?
Well, he could be anywhere, but knowing him, he's going to try and steal something from the most important person of the time.
Exactly what I was thinking. Now, who would that be?
I would imagine it would be the first president of the United States, George Washington.
Golly, that could have disastrous results, Dr. Floyd. We've got to stop Dr. Steve. But how will we get close to George Washington?
Well, Washington loved artists and loved having his portrait painted, so we could pose as...
garbage men trying to collect his trash?
Yeah. Or... we could pose as artists and ask to paint his portrait.
Hey, that's a good idea too. Now, which one do you think we should try?
We should pose as artists and ask to paint his portrait?
Oh, okay. We'll do it your way this time. I'll go and get the costumes.
As Dr. Floyd, Dr. Grant, and Chips get on their disguises, let's catch up with President George Washington, who is just returning to his house after an early afternoon walk.
There you are. I thought you weren't going to make it back in time to meet the public.
Oh, come on, Martha. You know I'd never miss a chance to meet the citizens of the country.
Well, you need to stop taking these walks around the grounds. It's getting chilly out there. You'll catch a death of pneumonia.
Oh, I will not. Any messages come in while I was out?
Well, yes. Two of them. One from Thomas Jefferson and the other from Alexander Hamilton. They're both throwing parties to discuss politics, and we're invited. They're on the same night, though. One is on the left, and the other is on the right side of town.
Oh, brother. I tell you, Martha, I can't stand these political parties. We'll have to attend part of both. Guess I'll go get dressed to meet the public.
As George Washington enters the house through the back door to freshen up, let's turn our attention to the front door, where we find that evil mastermind Dr. Steve and his sock-shaped assistant Fidget.
No, Fidget, you look fine. Now remember, we're posing as fans of the president, and we're just here to tell him that he's doing a great job. Yes, and then we'll find a way to get into another part of the house, and we'll find a spot to hide where we can swipe his teeth. Well, most people keep their false teeth in a glass beside their bed, so we'll just slip off into his room and hide under his bed. When he falls asleep tonight, we'll sneak out, swipe his teeth, and be back in the time and spaceship before anyone notices.
Oh, hello there. How long have you two respectable-looking gentlemen been out here?
We've only just arrived. We've come to tell you what a fantastic job you're doing running the country.
Well, that's very nice of you. I'm only one man, though. It takes every citizen to make this country great.
Ah, but we need a strong leader. Someone who can point us in the right direction. Someone whose face will look good on the money.
What's that now?
Oh, nothing. Say, speaking of pointing us in the right direction, could we use your bathroom?
My what?
Oh, that's right, no bathrooms. Your chamber pot?
Oh, you're sure. It's upstairs, down the hallway, and first door on your right. Oh, looks like I've got some more visitors heading up this way.
As Dr. Stephen Fidget enter the home of George Washington, up the path come our heroes, Dr. Floyd, Dr. Grant, and Chips, all dressed up as artists.
Let me do all the talking, Dr. Grant. And Chips, although your mastery of the art of conversation is legendary, the best thing for you to do is just keep quiet.
I still think we should have dressed as garbage men, though.
Hush, Dr. Grant. Well, good afternoon there, sir.
Well, good afternoon to you. I can tell by your accoutrement that you three must be artists.
That we are. We were wondering if perhaps we could paint the portrait of the leader of the free world.
I would be honored and I would be delighted. Come on in.
As our heroes set up their easels in the drawing room of Washington's house, let's check in with Dr. Stephen Fidget, who are standing in the hallway upstairs.
Look, Fidget, there's Washington's bedroom there. And look, there on his nightstand, a glass of water. I told you that's where he'd keep his false teeth. Now let's just crawl under the bed and wait.
Dr. Stephen Fidget crawl under the presidential bed, and as they do, let us return to the drawing room, where we find Dr. Floyd, Dr. Grant, and Chips beginning to paint the president.
Okay, Mr. President, can we get a little smile there? Is that it?
Yeah, I'm afraid that's the best to get. You see, It takes everything I have to keep these false teeth in my mouth. They're spring-loaded, and I have to keep my jaw clenched to keep them closed.
That must be why he looks so stern on the dollar bill.
I've been thinking about getting a set of those new wooden teeth they have, but I just get nervous about termites.
Yeah, I see what you mean, sir. Any sign of Dr. Steve?
No, Dr. Floyd. Chip says he's picked up two heat sources from under George Washington's bed, though.
That must be them. We gotta keep Washington here so we can keep an eye on him.
What was that?
Nothing. You're looking great there, Mr. President. This is gonna be a great painting. You have the kind of chiseled good looks they'll carve into a mountain someday.
Oh, really? That's very nice of you to say.
Our heroes continue to paint Washington late into the night. With his deep appreciation of art, the president has no qualms about modeling that long. As the evening hours have worn on, though, Dr. Steve and Fidget have begun losing the fight to stay awake while hiding under Washington's bed.
Fidget, I'm getting so sleepy. We'll have to take turns staying awake until Washington comes to bed. You take the first shift, Fidget. I'll just take a little nappy-wappy.
As both Dr. Steve and Fidget drift off to dreamland, let us return to the drawing room where Martha Washington checks in on the painting process.
You about done, George? You've been in here for hours.
We're almost done, Mrs. Washington. We're just trying to get the likeness correct.
Yeah, honey, you can't rush art. And besides, I find it relaxing to sit completely motionless for hours at a time.
Well, I could paint this room with an eyelash faster than you three could paint a portrait. He's not even smiling. Imagine if you had to paint his teeth, too. Oh, you'd be here for years. Oh, I am heading up to bed. George, you should consider doing the same.
I'll be up momentarily, hun. Let's pick up the pace, guys. Don't want to make the first lady angry.
We're almost done, sir.
What are we going to do, Dr. Floyd? Dr. Steve and Fidget are still hiding under Washington's bed.
I know, Dr. Grant, but we can't stay too much longer or they'll throw us out. We'll just have to wait outside and see if...
Just then, a shriek of surprise rings out from the upstairs bedroom as the startled Martha Washington finds Dr. Steve and Fidget hiding under the bed.
Martha! Martha! Are you okay?
Spies! George! There's spies in the house! Get out of here!
Tumbling down the stairs comes Dr. Steve and Fidget, who are sleepy-eyed and panicked. Martha Washington is following close behind, brandishing a parasol at the two villains.
George, grab them! They're spying on us, I know it!
Spies, huh? I'll teach you a thing or two. Come back here!
Run!
Dr. Steve and Fidget manage to open the front door as George Washington lunges at them. They slam the door behind them, and George Washington slams into the closed door at full force.
Are you okay, Mr. President?
Huh? Yeah, I'm okay. I think I chipped my one good tooth. Can't believe there were spies in my house. We're going to have to set up some kind of secret service to prevent this from happening in the future. I'll have to remember to put that on my to-do list.
Well, Mr. President, we're all done with the painting. Thank you so much for letting us paint you.
Now, hold on. Let me take a look at it.
Actually, we'll have to send you a copy of it because we have to let it dry. We'll give it to our friend Gilbert Stewart and he'll give it to you.
All right, then. Good evening, gentlemen. Wait, Gilbert who?
Oh, you'll meet him someday, sir.
It sure was a pleasure to meet you, sir.
The pleasure was mine. Now, if you don't mind, I'm going to head up to my bed. I have a strong belief that anyone who doesn't get a full 8 hours of shut-eye will suffer from arrested development.
I should have seen that one coming. Good night, and thank you, Mr. President.
Our heroes head off into the night back to their time and spaceship. They make one brief stop in the year 1795 at the art studio of one Gilbert Stewart.
Excuse me, Mr. Stewart, sir?
Yes, I'm very busy. What is it?
I'm a big fan of your work. I just wanted to give you this painting of George Washington. I think you should take a crack at painting him.
Washington, eh? That's a pretty good idea. Say, this painting isn't even finished.
Oh, well, you can finish it. I gotta run.
Dr. Floyd climbs back aboard the time and spaceship and heads back out into the time and space stream. Where will Dr. Steve head next in his bumbling quest to pillage history? Will Dr. Floyd and his crew ever be able to stop him? And just what does George Washington sound like without his teeth in?
Spies! Spies in my home! Cease!
Good night, George.
Good night, Martha.
Find out the answers to these questions next time on the Radio Adventures of Dr. Floyd!